go all the way to Merry England, beautiful London, Catholic Answers Live app listener Chris. Thank you for staying up, Chris, and for calling tonight. Welcome.
No worries. Thank you.
What's on the go, Chris? What's on your mind?
Okay, so there's been some saints from the early church. I'm thinking like St. Christopher, for
yes.
example. And I think historians have proven some of them to be myth or not true.
Mm-hmm.
And so for all those who have made that saint who is a myth their patron saint and pray to them, are their prayers wasted?
Sure. Great question. Mm-hmm. Chris, first of all, when it comes to St. Christopher, there may well be an actual St. Christopher. I believe that there actually is a St. Christopher. But remember, Chris, some of the earliest saints, including St. Christopher, were not canonized by popes, but they are made saints by popular acclamation, right? By popular acclamation, Chris. What we know, Chris, is when a saint is canonized by the pope, that is an infallible act of the papal magisterium. So when he canonizes someone, that someone is in heaven, and we have the certainty of faith on that. Now, theoretically, Chris, though I don't believe St. Christopher is one of them, theoretically, there could have been a saint or two or three that were made so by popular acclamation that could, well, why am I having a hard time with acclamation
today?
Because
it's acclimactation.
Yeah, that's it. By popular acclamation could theoretically not be real. I don't actually know of any, but that's theoretically possible.
Maybe acclaim might be easier way to say
yes,
popular
acclaim. That's right. All right, but Chris, here's the key. When you're talking about the saints of the early church, like let's take the fathers of the church. We have so much not only do we have the authority of the church, but we have so much historical evidence for their existence, testimonies of, you know, just enormous numbers of people that there is no reason to doubt, for example, the existence of St. Clement of Rome or St. Ignatius of Antioch or St. Justin Martyr. In fact, the evidence is absolutely overwhelming. In order to deny, Chris, the historicity of the person of Jesus Christ, the apostles, and the early saints. I mean, you would have to reject all of ancient history because there is literally hundreds of more times of proof for their existence than for the existence of any of the figures of ancient history you want to talk about, whether, you know, we could talk about Cicero or whomever. Does that help at all, Chris?
It does, yeah. Say if someone did choose a patron saint who wasn't actually a real saint,
yes.
What happens to those people's prayers?
Right.
That's
a great question. Now, again, I don't know of a case where that's happened, but if theoretically that would happen, remember, if it's kind of like the question we often get, Patrick, about people say, well, what if you're praying to someone and actually that person is in hell? You know, what happens to those prayers? Well, God takes your intention, Chris. You're willing to pray to that saint, and you will merit graces for yourself and others in accordance with that intention and your your dispositions in your own spiritual life cooperating with God's grace. So in other words, Chris, your prayers are going to be efficacious whether or not that saint actually exists.
Chris, before you go, I wonder if I can piggyback just a little bit to broaden this out a little bit. St. George and the golden legend of the dragon.
Right.
We're not required to believe there was a dragon and a sword. So maybe it's some legendary accretions can get added on to a legitimate saint. I don't know much about St. George, but I know he looms large in England.
Yes, and he is a saint. But I think he's talking about more the saint himself or herself did not exist. And St. Christopher got a lot of airtime in recent years because it was wrongly reported that, you know, Vatican declares that St. Christopher doesn't exist. And no, what happened was he was removed from the calendar, as is often happens at different times in church history, a saint will be removed, other saints are added, and so forth. And this became, you know, Saint Christopher actually doesn't exist. And
right.
actually, that's not the case. That's not what happened. But that question, and I think, Chris, this is what you're getting at, it did bring up all of these questions about, well, theoretically, that could happen. You could have had a saint who was made a saint by popular acclamation, hence
yeah.
Not really exist. Theoretically, that's possible, even if that hasn't happened. So what happens mm-hmm. if you pray to that saint? He's not really a saint. And I think, Chris, the essential answer is, of course, we don't want to be praying to a saint that doesn't exist. And there's no reason to believe there are such saints. If they're on the Roman calendar, you have... the certainty, again, if they've been canonized, you have the certainty of faith, but you have this general certainty that you're praying to a person that can hear your prayers. But if in that crazy perhaps world, maybe you're praying to somebody that's not there, just as you may be praying to someone you know in your own private prayers who may not be in heaven.
Yeah,
God is going to use your intention, and you are going to merit accordingly. I think that gets at it.
Yeah, and from a strictly historical analysis point of view, it's impossible to disprove someone's existence in history. How do you verify that they didn't exist?
Yeah, it becomes very difficult. But you can look, and if you say this saint was not mentioned until 600 years after he died, mm-hmm. there are differing stories radically 600 years after he lived. You're on pretty shaky ground.
Well, the question becomes, whose onus is it to find someone on the Roman calendar who's been, we got it all wrong.
Yeah. And like Chris, I said, it's never been done.
Yeah. If
it's
you can do it, Chris, give us back. We love evidence. We love truth. Amen. And we love that you stayed up late for us and asked your question. Thank you, Chris.
Thank you, Chris.
All right.